horse or two stuck on your tube, stuck on your tackle.
Yeah. Right, well, there we are. So now we'll look at the bottom of the row. Yes, please. Well, there's not much debris on the bottom after all that.
The rower there.
Excuse me, I can't see, Chris.
Sorry, because I'm in the light.
Just there, that little red thing.
Red thing. No.
Yes. It could be, it could be. I can't see.
Yes, there is this. Yeah. That dot. Yeah.
Yes, I'm seeing what you're talking about.
No.
No, forgive me, I don't think it is a willow.
No.
No, not in fact. It's possibly a bit of red propolis. Anyhow, I'm just going to take this to the side.
Yeah. Mm. Enjoying this?
Is it where these was the spy colony I was looking at? And actually,
it's the M1?
No,
I haven't got that far yet. We're still on number two.
Is this a double brood because you've put two together?
That's right.
In the winter.
Two brood boxes. So at one time it's been strong enough to justify that. Obviously, isn't now. Oh, that's fine, thank you. Yes, fine, okay. Excuse me. But it doesn't justify two. And what I would do if you had is I just take the brews from the box, the combs that have got brewed in from there, and put them in the top box. Right. Just have the one box down, you see, and take the surplus box away. But Morris is in charge of these, and I'd rather he decided what he wants to do with them. Okay.
I'm just doing it
by the way. That's right, so we've turned this one off. I do hope we're going to find a better colony than the end. Any action points? Consolidate into one brew box, that's what I put. Consolidate into one brew box. And put Queen Marked Blue, please. If you just put blue on the Queen, it'll indicate that so we've seen it. And in terms of brood, well, say 2.5 combs of brood. I think it's still allowance for a few groups. But it's going to be well into the end of May before this is doing any good at all. I mean, this colony ought to be a lot more bees and that amount of brood sometime early in February. And here we are, another 2 months later.
Is that the cold weather that's done that primarily?
Well, it won't have helped at all, but no, it isn't basically cold weather. It's basically the bees died off. A lot of the older bees have died off as the summer's gone by, as the autumn has gone by into winter. And they just haven't managed to...
Not giving them any more.
No, there's no point. No point in feeding them. They're not taking it down.
This is very nature group.
They're putting in pollen there, they've got their little baskets.
I saw a very violet coloured pollen, it's a very purpley one, yeah. One of my frames was completely filled with pollen.
There's that ivy hanging there on the end, yeah.
I got more smoke for that. How are we doing?
Wow! This
Oh, they didn't do him bad, but they didn't take him the feed down.
There's quite a lot of brood, isn't there?
I'll put the crane board on this time. Put the feeder on for the rest. Crocky, they haven't got any of it down.
Maybe they don't like it,
Mum. It is the right stuff, is it?
Well, I'm not going to say one thing or the other. All I know is my chairman said, give the bees that. What on earth it is, I do not know.
Are you trying to suggest this is a bit watery there, Neil?
No. I'm suggesting, I was just trying to suggest there might be something else.
What? Like
I don't say anything.
Well, like gin, perhaps.
We did have someone feed the bees with acid.
Oh my god. Wow.
Acid, and boy, if you take a whiff of acetic acid, forget about testing it, it just about kills you.
Is that what you use for?
Yeah, whatever you're going to say.
Moss.
You use it for basically nearly everything. It'll kill. What will it kill?
Moss, isn't it?
Kill bees.
It'll kill pollen mite and I don't know a host of other things.
Some people use some wax moss, don't they?
You use it, or I'll stick it on there right away.
You want that on the top?
Yeah. Put it in the shed and the moss will be there a week after.
Yeah.
All these horrible questions. A week ago.
Yeah.
Went on before Easter.
Oh, God.
So that's some time ago.
Yeah.
It's a bit quiet.
So I would have thought any hive doing well would have took that down easy within a week. But there we go.
Wow.
Got loads of brace cone on the end of it.
Got some old honey there.
Some old honey.
12 months old nearly.
Got a bit of pollen.
Yeah, not much here.
Shall we think about moving your bees down sometime middle of next week?
Nice,
plenty of pollen.
You've got to start thinking about coming back. You're back to school in a
week.
Is
it worth pulling the end frame out now?
Well, yeah.
Well, I mean,
I would.
Do you want to just stick that one down there?
Is your wheelbarrow in the garage or you leave it outside?
It should come out quite easy anyway.
Well, it won't be till at least Wednesday anyway.
It's a bit
well done. Because I've taken my box, all the bees in your box, and put a queen excluder on.
Yeah,
but there was a little bit of brood in my colony. Yeah. And what I was going to do, I was going to shake the bees off, take out the brood that's left in there, and then your bees can all go in one evening when they stop flying. And then you've got them. You've seen that more bees than I got. I've lost the hive now to make me feel uncomfortable. I looked in yesterday. The bees have been flying, you know.
Bit of pollen.
No problem.
Bit of brood.
I looked in the hive and no queen. Plenty of, sealed drone brood, raised cats.
Oh, that's a bit of patch.
Yeah. So,
that's a nice, it's quite a nice patch actually, that is.
Yeah.
And there's lots of stores around the outside. There's nectar in there.
Really.
Pollen, a bit of nectar. Not bad that side
that
either.
It cuts your eyes down, doesn't it? Yeah, that's food that's nice, coming in now. 5 weeks. It's coming in 5 weeks.
Right.
5 weeks. No, I haven't been for vegetable Christmas. Something like that, I don't know. Long time ago.
they're coming late this year. See, usually they say towards the end of April.
Same as that one?
About the end of May, no.
Yeah. Good brew. So queen.
The weather.
It's a bit spread out, but plenty of nectar. Plenty of grubs in the bottom there. Little grubs. See? Yeah. In the middle, right in the middle. Loads.
No, this is the third one, isn't it? You can't curb the first one.
No, this is the
patch of fruit.
Yeah, this is the third one with a reasonable.
Yeah. I don't count that.
Reasonably.
Is it coming out or is something?
No, that's stored.
The stores.
Didn't they? Sorry, do you want a frame or something? Might be better in the bottom one because then underneath
there's nothing on the frame
fruit.
Out here except food.
There's an old queen cell there on the other side.
Yeah.
That's a healthy life.
No, not exactly.
No eggs are not here because it could have been, they could have united. Queen could still be here.
So you're just going to put the roof straight on the wall?
Then on the white bed, it should still be on here. Because if anything, they could put on a super. Unless maybe Morrison's trying to get some food stores in there rather than putting them on.
Leave them muddy and go on.
Do
you want some cooking out of them?
Pretty much on this one. Should get one with brood in that one.
Yeah, there's some brood
on there.
Get out all my shots like that with Jack doing it.
Eggs.
Oh, what did you want? Yeah.
It's looking like it works.
This is my Britain movie.
Yeah.
No,
I'll
let
you get off.
Okay. No, they didn't. There were a couple of anomalies which, given that we paid that chap for the
year,
was a bit of surprising, I thought.
Could do with a thing.
Because it was something that had been put down in support of keeping children safe.
Yeah, it was in there because we've got the eggs improved, but if we could find our own one.
So I changed it to the low-level hogs and the outside play equipment that was to give children the opportunity to have adventure. Yeah, and stay safe. But it's not a foregone conclusion.
Okay.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
The pruding cells are the ones with drones in.
You can let me know that we've got a car door in there. Because it makes sense. Because all you need to know is if you've got the big couple dogs, maybe. So, you know, whatever.
I've got one up my back, I think.
No, he's already
this one then. Come on, girl.
Okay. Now, it's...
Can I take it off?
Yes, please. I better have that available because I don't know what to use a light at all.
It's pouring out.
They haven't taken much of it, have
no,
they?
No, they haven't taken it.
And there doesn't seem much flying. Well, I don't know. But certainly in the last week I should have thought. Then we should have taken down by now. But there's nothing, there's not very much happening at the front here, which worries me a little bit. Just.
Well, this is
all that. No, keep it.
Do you want to put it back in the pot?
I wouldn't do it if it was honey,
to feed them.
Because honey would smell. No honey in it. Come on, nothing's obvious in there. Where is it?
The cat's put it in to empty it.
What have we got on here now then? Gentleman who's doing the...
It's number one, I think, on the other side.
We call it number one.
Number one.
And
okay.
At the moment it's on a brood box, the deep one, and it's on a super, so what we call a brood and a half.
Right.
Not strictly a half, but it's a super. I mean, that's about 9 inches and that's about 6 inches. So it's a...
Well, no,
and my colleague here is having a look to see.
There's grubs in there.
Is that?
I think so.
Very funny grubs on the head. Look, let's just. It's easy to make the mistake, but what there is some old hive honey, and the bees are taking some of the honey out, and therefore it looks as though he's got curled bits in or something. Right, there's this. Now, notice two. I'm going to go around the back of them. They don't work from the front. These are positioned in what we call the warm way. There's two ways, as you can see quite easily. They could be with the combs facing front to back, or they can be side to side, and the bees coming in and out at the front. And whilst the more traditional way is the cold way, many of us prefer the warm way, because it's a great deal easier to manage the bees. It doesn't make any difference to the bees whatsoever. But it's certainly a lot easier to manage, because you just start from the back. Start from the back, and the bees at the front, normally then, at this time of the year. And this is what we call a cover cloth, which we just roll on there like that. Keeps the bees down, whilst we have a look at the combs. Have you got a...
There's
nothing.
No,
there's nothing to talk about in this. There's nothing in it. The bees have had the stores during the winter. They've taken them out to live on, and now it's empty. Now that one's got some of the syrup that has been fed to them. And there's two or three dead bees on there, which we'll just take a note of. That's a full comb of winter stores. And there'll be no, I don't think there'll be any brood up here. And that's also a sealed comb of very old stores from last summer. And there's not necessarily anything wrong with it. It might be granulated, but if the bees want, they need it, and if they want to use the space, then they'll move it. But we do have here an extremely weak colony. And there's some bees. Now that's an interesting comb. That's the first comb next door to the brood. And it's got pollen in it, new pollen. You see the various colours?
The orange and the yellow.
All
pollen.
The different colours there, you can see. Anybody want to look at it, Rich? Pass it round?
We've got gloves on.
These bees
like
are
that.
Not in any stinging mood.
No, they're not. They're quite big, quiet, aren't they?
They're very quiet, yes.
Oh, food.
Now then, so we've got a queen.
Mm,
and we've got some brood there, right?
Mm.
And it's a nice coloured, fawn coloured, straw coloured covering. Mm. It's fairly regular, there's a bit of a gap there, but it's not too bad.
Where's the queen, sorry?
No, well, the queen is here, that's all I'm saying.
Oh, you know she's there. But
well, because there's brood.
Okay.
And young larvae.
Why are they...
Which you can see there, the white is the young larvae.
Right.
Right. Caterpillars.
Yeah, you like to, that.
I don't think the queen's on there, you couldn't see her anyhow. Now, so Mr. Taker, note taker, we've got brood, we've also got some chalk brood.
Where it says brood eggs,
we've got brood eggs, larvae, and under diseases, you can put a tick for chalk brood. I'll just put the word chalk in.
Chalk, okay.
There's only three there, but there are some there.
Oh, okay.
And there's a nice circle there, is that actually? You can see how the queen has developed the brood nest here. It started off with a small area there, right, and the bees were fed and they developed and sealed, and then when they were sealed, she then laid more eggs around the side, extended the brood nest, and then meanwhile the bees in here have emerged and some more eggs and larvae developing inside. Right, so you have to visualize that this is now in its second stage, and there is a bee emerging.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You can just see its tongue
flipping it.
Mandibles. I'm sorry, it's a bit difficult to. I'll put that one back now. Yes, thank you.
What did you want to put down for space? Sorry.
Yeah. Well, for the moment, we're on a brood and a half.
How long does it take you to have?
But we don't need the brood. I don't think. But anyhow, we shall see them.
So were they brood in here rather than in the brood chamber?
Well, the tendency is to move up during the course of the winter.
How long are they in for before they come out after they've laid the egg?
After they laid the egg,
is it 6 weeks?
It's 3 weeks.
3 weeks.
3 weeks from laying the egg to the emergence of the adult bee, the full bee. Now, these grubs here that are sealed over, they're at least 9 days old, 9 days after the egg. The larvae, the egg hatches in 3 days. The larvae are fed for 6 days, they're sealed over, and then 12 days later, these emerge. Drone brood takes 3 days longer.
With the drones of the male?
Yes.
So will this colony actually build itself up again?
Well, given plenty of time.
Yeah.
Plenty of time. And hoping we haven't done any damage to it.
If not, would you introduce it to another colony, or...?
No, I think perhaps what one might do is strengthen it by putting some brood in from another colony.
Right.
Did you find the queen, by the way?
No, I didn't. No,
we're not
going to put that
in.
Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right, so there should be 11 in, so we'll space it for 11. Because down below, you see, there should be either metal ends or what these call Hoffman spacers.
Mm-hmm.
But there, well, those aren't. Sorry. It wouldn't be, would it? But Hoffman spaces look like that.
Be quiet things, aren't they?
They're very nice and quiet,
yes.
Well, it's a nice day.
Yes.
And they're not a... Well, the Hoffman spaces are a little elbow of wood there. Instead of going all the way down, it's just a little elbow. We call those Hoffman spaces. These are a wide space. So I'm trying to get them to, because I want them to match the combs underneath. You with me? The combs underneath will be 11 in the box. Well, that's the best we can do.
Will all the mice
in this area be defending
it? That would be best in the
what, in this apiary?
Well,
hopefully not. Hopefully not, this is a weak one. Yeah.
Right, so we'll move on to down below, but has come up with the use of the stores. You see, now that's very light. There's really nothing in there at all. That was heavier than this is. You know, this is a bigger box. Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And the vision board at the end. Well, that's a lousy cone, isn't it?
Mm.
It's so I mean, the sooner we can replace that, the better. It's got mould on it. It's obviously very old. If we hold it up to the light like that, we can see it hasn't actually had more than one, at most two rounds of brood in it, because you can see through it. I don't know.
There's a blue there, a blue pin.
Well,
there.
Yes, I think that's coincidental. Mm. Well, you can see how bad this pollen is, can't you?
Mm.
Is that disease or is it?
It's just a very bad winter, right. And a weak colony.
Uh-huh.
And there could be some disease as well.
Uh oh.
Sorry. Oh.
Go on, I've got it.
I thought I'd left it behind.
No, you have now.
Yeah, I've got it. Sorry. Look at that. Yeah. What a mess. There's some bits of chalk brood on the bottom. This is dead bees, and this is where they've spent the winter, above there, uncapping the stores that they had and dropping all the bits and pieces. And there's lots of chalk brood in it, look as well. So the colony has been very badly hampered by that condition. Right. Now then, she's thinking quickly. I'm wondering where to put this stuff, all this rubbish.
I should go and bring a bit of newspaper.
That would be very helpful. Chef. Thank you very much indeed. Yes. The chalk brood is in a sense highly infectious. But chalk brood spores, it's a fungus, are in the air and in the beehives all the time. Whether it shows or not like this depends on the general condition of the bees. I mean, we hopefully will find all the other colonies are free of it, but under the, if they were run down and so on, then chalk brood would take over and cause further damage to them. Right.
Is there any varroa in that?
There shouldn't be in that itself, but the varroa will be on the bees.
On the bees.
And inside the grubs.
Right.
Yes, you just want enough to go take it onto and then fold it up. And they might have more on the other cup.
Yeah.
What I'd have liked to have done, of course, would be to change this cut box from this floorboard.
Does the floor come out?
Yes, this comes out.
Yeah.
And that's got more chalk, the chalk mummies. What you can see are the mummies, we call them mummies, those chalk pellets. So there's none down here, fortunately. But that is all cappings from honey that has been opened up to keep the bees. Now the primary purpose of this board here, it's going to be very difficult for it to do until it's properly cleaned, washed and even repainted, is to test for varroa mites. Because the varroa mites, dead varroa mites, will drop off there and onto here, particularly if we've been treating the colony with one of the miticides. And so it's a useful means of telling how badly infested the colony is. That's what it's there for. It's not really very practical to do it like this. This is the first time I've looked at these bees, and there's no
one. Can you get out?
And she can't get out now. Let me sit down. There you are. Oh, you've got that.
She's still in there. She's still in.
Oh well.
No, she's coming up. She's coming up.
I'm sorry for her. Perhaps when I put this back on and take it out. I mean, the easiest thing is to leave it out there for 10 minutes. Right, now then, so we're going to look at this now. And, put it on the top. The cloth serves two purposes, marginally to keep some heat in, and primarily to stop the bees from flying up. If the bee colony is more populous, it would be. She's terrible cold, terrible cold. And then, well,
in. Now then, there we've got some very old, dead brood.
So at some time in the past, the queen has laid up brood and the bees have had to desert it before it all emerged. Deserted, the bees died off, so they couldn't look after it. So sometime in the autumn, there's been quite a loss of bees, and therefore you get these bits of brood.
Would you have to replace all that?
Oh yes, yes, all this has to be changed. That would be what we put under action, replace all combs. I mean, they're no good at all, you see. You could say, well, I've got some pollen in there, if I'm still working, well, it's not worth it, is it? And when you look at that, can you see? You can't see through it. Right. It's such an old comb. The best place for that is actually in the bin. There's some wax in it, but it's hardly worth trying to extract the wax from it. You get less than half an ounce of wax from that. The other thing about this is that this is not the, you know, they've bitten all the comb around the bottom and then replaced it and rebuilt it. This is supposed to be worker. Those are worker cells, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Worker cells. These are drone cells. Mm. Have you seen that when...
Yeah.
Have you all been to Jack's classes?
No.
None of you?
No.
Have any of you been to any classes at all, or read any books?
I've read, no. read books, so, watched DVDs.
You know,
yes.
Well, do stop me if I just assume that you know something. Please, you know, I've been... No good going on, and you think, what are you doing there?
These are the frames that you were telling about.
That's right, and these have got bottom spacing.
Yeah.
Right. See those lugs there?
Yeah.
Those elbows, shoulders rather. Right, well, that's where the bees were, down in the bottom there, during the winter months. And there's no brood in here at all. And all the combs and everything.
So we haven't not seen the queen then?
No, she must be. I must have missed her. Which is very easy to do. So I'm just putting it back and closing it up and marking it for destruction. In fact, all the combs. To Jim and Morris decided. That's very disappointing, look at that. I don't think we'll disturb them again. We'll try to find the queen on the other one. Quickly over.
It's number two on the front of this
round. Is it? Right. We've got number two there, please.
Yeah, number two.
Yes, got two on the front. Right. And the smoker is. Have you done it on the top?
Done the front.
On the top. And then I lift this up.
Looks like health here, doesn't it?
A bit better.
Right, right, thank you very much, yes. We don't want them to abscond. You can hear them buzzing away, running away.
So during the winter then, have they not had a queen excluded between
No.
because they've been eating the stuff at the top?
Well, one doesn't want to get to the position where the stores are all in one box and the queen is in the other.
Right.
If you had a queen excluded between them, for instance, then certainly you can record this on a double brood box, double brood chamber, two broods. If you had a queen excluded between them and the bees used all the stores down below and wanted to move up above, of course the queen couldn't go with them, could they? And one has known that happen. You know, it's not just an idle possibility, it's a real possibility if you forget to take your queen excluders away at the end of the season. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now that's 12, and it's just too many in a box. A box is designed for it, but in practical terms, it's just too many. Instead, they're either called national hives, because they're a national size, and each brood frame has got a theoretical maximum of 5,000 cells, 2,500 on each side. In every square inch, there's 25 worker cells, when it's drawn nice and perfectly. Now these are this is totally different. Now I don't think that's a nice coat. Mm. This is even new pollen, and we're only on number two. Okay. I don't get to. We're in it. Thank you very much. Why does that look white then?
Well, that's good honey and well sealed, and the wax sealing has been done in such a way that there's a very small air bubble between the honey, the ripened honey, and the comb, wax seal. And those others where the wax over the honey
look,
was dark.
Green.
Green. Nooks. Yeah. Oh my goodness
well
me.
Well done, Stan.
That's Doug.
Oh, Doug.
Tony, rather.
Tony, yeah. I'm not sure. I knew it was
three names.
Tony Douglas.
Yeah.
I never remember
that's
that.
His name.
Not to market.
Well, I'd love to, but I haven't got a queen cage. By the time I do it, I'm afraid she's going to be...
You haven't lost it, have you?
It's there.
No, well, that one's just, by the way, stung me. That's
oh
not
dear.
The queen.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right down there?
Oh, yeah.
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 On the strap here.
And the strap.
Oh, what a good idea. Oh, what a good idea.
You got it?
I've got it here, yes, and as long as she stays there, we can wait a minute. That's very good to spot it, because there's nothing to expect it there. Is your camera very good? Right, thank you very much indeed. I'm going to let it go on to there. I'm going to let it go on to there. And she's there somewhere now.
And she's just here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, thank you. It was my big head, sorry, so I just want to get out of the way. There she is.
Right, now if we do this nice and gently, she gets caught. And come on, that's that.
There, good girl, stay there.
Oh, just don't let her out for a minute.
No.
Thank you. Just let that dry off.
There was just one queen in the colony.
Yes.
Now I'm going to take this next comb out so I can put that back easily. Can you just lift it up for a minute? Thank you very much. Excuse me,
the bees
I can't
get
it out.
Oh,
sorry.
Sorry?
I thought the bees would attack you because you handed it.
No.
No, no, I don't think they realise that.
She's coming out. Is that okay?
She can't get out. Now, there she is.
Oh, brilliant.
Okay.
Yeah. So then in future when you lift them out you can find them.
Yeah. Now some of us don't like the colouring schemes and I don't like blue.
What's my favourite colour, blue?
I love that blue myself,
yeah.
Yes, but not as a marking.
No.
Because blue on a brown body doesn't stand out. Yellow and white do.
Mm.
And I would always mark them with yellow and white.
Okay, please.
Right, there's some brood in there and eggs. So, would you like to pass that round and let people look? There's eggs on that side, I think, all the way around there.
Well, will the queen not fly away?
Yeah, she flies.
Even if she was an old one. She's flexing her wings out of it, aren't she? Coming on the edge there.
She's gone on the edge, look.
Going up.
Yeah, I